The Redwood Forest. Do you know about the world tree from which all others are born? I have seen its mighty children, ancestor groves whose thrones of noble feet hold down the roots of earth worn. A tribe who was tall since memory was new stood stilted oaken pillars that climb and crown the heavens kiss with manes of glory. Even the arrogant fools of men must bow to the sequoias as royalty, whose records bear wisdom we cannot hear, though they speak with a voiceless might, in vigilance as sentinels of Earth's humanity.
Thank you.
on Route 66. Soda shop, lollipop, biggest ball of yarn. Do we dare stop, hun? Honk! The tour map flirts dangerously, with the broad open window, winking her crisp edges with a snap to the vistas of gas stations, eagles, and crows. She thinks she is perfect hostess for showing us the places to be, but becomes wildly offended by the shotgun navigator's snore. Such rude manners, says she. With a humph, she bows a vain curtsy, outstretching her glove to her suave dance partner, Air. A dramatic exit, indeed. None the wiser, I sink into un sueño, an idol of fluttering postcards and dusky tongue tumbleweeds that fade like memories.
Thank you.
The Melting Pot, The New Colossus by Emma Lazarus. Not like the brazen giant of Greek fame, with conquering limbs astride from land to land. Here at our sea-washed sunset gates shall stand a mighty woman with a torch, whose flame is the imprisoned lightning, and her name, Mother of Exiles. From her beacon hand glows worldwide welcome, her mild eyes command the air-bridged harbor that twin cities frame. Keep, ancient lands, your storied pomp, cries she with silent lips. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed, to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door.
Thank you.
Bluegrass, BB&B, by Valerie Coleman. You'd think it happened in all grays and brown, the way grandpas remembered it. Suspenders, thumb-hooked, and steely jaw glinting at that old barn. And when his eyes took a long breath, his heart spoke of raising it the right way. Decency and respect for the frame, to be shored up with nails and pegs of grit and sweat, then hoisted up with ropes and levers of integrity. Some of your neighbors will stand in balance on that frame when it goes up, he said, to keep watch and secure it strong enough to stand in all seasons. Once that barn was up, we sat down for a meal. 10 hams, 75 cakes, 175 pies, and 500 tarts were all gone in an hour. Then came the bourbon and bluegrass.